Hello all, this video is on doubling farmers' income. You may be very familiar with this term as this is very frequently discussed in news, media, etc. Anyway, this video is on seeing the underlying reasons for doubling farmers' income. Then what is actually doubling farmers' income? We'll see the concept of this doubling farmers' income. Then we'll also see what are the governmental actions or action plan to double farmers' income. Then what are the challenges before it and also some suggestions to make it real. First of all, let's understand why is there a need for doubling farmers' income. All the previous agriculture policies were concentrated on increasing agriculture productivity or to meet food security. That means it was all farm-centric. It was not farmer-centric. It means that there was a less recognition for increasing farmers' welfare or farmers' income. So this has led to this concentration on increasing agriculture productivity. Like it has resulted in increasing the food production by 45% per person food production. And also country has also become a net exporting agriculture commodity country. But this has led to, that means the lower concentration on farmer or his income has led to low income earned by farmers in this sector. And while comparing to this farmer's income with that of other sectors or non-agriculture workers, it's found that farmer income is very lower or the lowest income. So that is also the main reason for agrarian distress. This disparity between farmer's income and non-agriculture workers or other sector workers' income. The reduction in farmer's income. This is the main reason for agrarian distress. This also means that this agrarian distress can threaten agriculture sector in long term by decreasing the interest of people working in farming or the coming population showing disinterest to work further in agriculture sector because of its low remuneration. So there is a high need to double farmers' income so as to come up with better welfare for farmers or to decrease the disparity between farmers' income and a non-farmer or non-agriculturist income and also for a long-term support or long-term growth for agriculture sector. So we need to know about what is the actual concept of this doubling farmers' income. First, you ought to know what is the time frame for doubling this farmers' income. That is, it's found that 2015-16 year to 2022-23, financial 2022-23. This is the time frame, that means a gap of 7 years to increase farmers' income. And again understand that the base year here is 2015. So the farmers' income of the year 2015 has to be considered and this 2015 farmers' income has to be doubled in the year 2022. Then we'll have to understand what is to be doubled. Whether it is the total agriculture output or farmland output or the value addition to this farm product or the farm income or the farmer's income. So be very clear that it is the farmer's income to be doubled other than the output or value addition. Then again, when we consider this farmer's income, when we say that it is the farmer's income to be doubled, we also ought to know whether it is nominal income or real income. Nominal income, you may know that nominal income means it is the total monetary terms of income that is received by a farmer or the total cash received by the farmer as income. But real income means there is a difference here. Even inflation is adjusted. Okay? It is not just the cash as income received by the farmer. It is also like even real, I mean here inflation is also adjusted. So farmer's real income has to be doubled within this time span. Then again, we have to consider what are the sources. From which all sources this income from farmers has to be considered. So we know that this doubling farmers' income is a tedious task. So for that, to increase this farmer's income, so all the sources, from which all sources farmer can get income, that is within agriculture sector and outside agriculture sector, are considered, and it is not, so keep in mind, it is not within agriculture sector alone. The qualitative framework for doubling farmers' income has identified 7 areas. Okay? So we'll see the 7 areas, or these are the action plans or roadmap from the part of government to increase this farmers' income or double farmers' income. First one, it is by increasing the productivity out of agriculture sector. For that, now government is focusing on irrigation. So it's found that while using more of irrigation, or irrigation has the potential to double farmers' yield or agriculture yield. This government has come up with a program, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, and it is also one of the flagship program of government. So this program is seen like an end-to-end solution for all the problems in irrigation supply chain. And again, the aim of this program, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, is to make water or irrigation available to each farmland in our country. And again, it focuses on micro irrigation. So this says that the government's aim through this program is not to just expand irrigation in our country, it is also through some efficient irrigation technologies or efficient irrigation means. So both expansion of irrigation as well as water conservation is given focus through this program, and the motto of the program, more crop per drop, that is defined this fact. Then second, government focuses on effective use of different inputs needed in agriculture sector of farmland. That is giving more importance to how inputs are used or what inputs are used, like that of improved seeds or planting material, then soil health cards, organic farming. So to improve the efficiency of these inputs and reduce the wastage of inputs, and so as to improve agriculture productivity. So for this, government has come up with a number of programs like soil health card scheme, neem cotton urea scheme, Kisan call centers. So this, we can understand that by soil health card, each farmer will be able to understand the fertility of his soil, that means his farmland soil. Through this program, the quality of soil can be checked through this different labs, and that report can be provided to farmers. So the farmer can contribute to the fertilizers that is required in his farmland. So that can actually reduce the cost of cultivation by using only that required fertilizers. And again, this neem cotton urea can be seen as a program which reduces the wastage, or which reduces the huge diversion of urea to other sectors, and it results in greater effectiveness of this fertilizers in agriculture sector. Then government focuses on reducing post-harvest losses. That is, it's found that this reduction in post-harvest losses is so critical to increase farmers' income. For that, government come up with different programs, like that of providing loans against negotiable warehouse receipts with interest subvention scheme. Then again, government's focus on rural areas is to develop storage facilities and other integrated cold chain. So you'll have to understand that after the harvest, farmers must have good storage facilities. Otherwise, there will be this post-harvest losses, and it's amounting to somewhere around 30% of the total agriculture harvest. Next is to increase value addition to the farmers' products. For this, a well-defined program like Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sambandha Yojana, which aims at developing more food processing capabilities by linking that of forward and backward linkages, so as to come up with better agro-processing. So that is this program, so it can lead to better value addition for different agriculture products, so as to enhance farmers' income. The next area for thrust is agriculture marketing. It is well understood that to increase farmers' income, it is really essential to realize better price for farmers' products through agriculture markets. So even for that, government has come up with some novel programs like e-NAM or Electronic National Agriculture Market. This we have seen that it provides better transparency to farmers, or it can be seen like a network of existing mandis, existing APMC mandis, which is working on an electronic platform. So this agriculture market, which takes place through online means, which will provide better transparency and will decrease the exploitation and will provide better income to the farmers. Then even government has circulated Model APMC Act, like that of APLM 2017, which has got very good features or very good favorable features for the farmers, like that of opening up the agriculture market to the private players. Then again, even government promotes farmer producer organization. As this farmer producer organization has the potential to increase the voice of or to increase the bargaining power of farmers and to provide them with better income. So this farmer producer organization has the capability to increase the farmers' income by providing better bargaining voice for these farmers. Then the area of focus is on crop protection. As we know that agriculture sector is facing a lot of risk, especially related with natural vagaries, like that of floods, drought, or any uncertain natural conditions. So it is very important that there must be some form of crop protection for the farmers if there is any crop loss. A very good answer for this, government has come up with Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, a crop insurance program which is seen that it provides the lowest premium for farmers under this, and better technologies are used so that crop damage data can be accurate and also some assured can be received in a transparent and a timely manner. Government is focusing on, or its objective is to cover at least 50% of farmers under this crop insurance program. Government is focusing on improving horticulture, dairy or poultry, beekeeping, fisheries, so that the income from these allied activities can be improved and can improve the final farmers' income. And again, like that white revolution, blue revolution, or again using agroforestry or integrated farming or mixed farming, all these are promoted by government so as to increase farmers' income. Now let's see the main challenges for doubling farmers' income. If you look into 2002 to 2012 data, it's found that farmers' income has been increased only 3.5% per annum. So that says that if to improve or to double farmers' income by 2022, then it requires some 3 times higher effort and resources. Or it even says that we need extra investments. We have to come up with some around 6,40,000 crores as agriculture investments. This must be on the basis of 2011 prices. So this kind of agriculture investment must mainly come from government. That says that the government has to increase the investment by 22 times. So even if this kind of investment is made, then there are certain other challenges. How this investment will increase the productivity, or how much it will contribute to the productivity? There is no certainty about that. And even when that productivity, increased productivity is there, we don't know how it will contribute to increased income of farmers. Because it can be said, because recently we have seen many increase in production of different crops like that of pulses or onions has only actually decreased the price of these crops. So it is not necessary that increased production or productivity can necessarily contribute to increased income. The main reason was that the private players could not stock more than a limit as there was regulations and they could not play freely in the market. And again, if there was no such demand in the domestic market, then we could think about exports. But this is also a challenge we have. We do not have or nothing is mentioned about exports for different agriculture commodities for this increased productivity. Then again, one of the main problem within the agriculture sector or for low income of farmers is that the policy is always biased in terms of or in favor of consumers. So always prices are set considering the consumers. So almost it's always like anti-farmer, or that price will be lower and that does not reflect in rise in price for farm products. Then one another problem is that climate change. It's a great threat to agriculture sector. It found that data from network program on climate change says that climate change can decline agriculture production or productivity some around 4.5 to 9% of the present level in the medium term, that is from years 2010 to 2039, productivity can be declined by 4.5% or 9%. Then beyond 2040, it can lead to 25% reduction in productivity. So this means that this can hit our GDP growth by 2%. So this can reduce the GDP for country by 2% per annum. So these are the major challenges for increasing farmers' income. So we can come up with certain challenges to remove the already seen challenges or better ways to increase farmers' income. One of the better ways to increase farmers' income can be seeing the China model. So it is found that in the year 1978 to 84, that means within 6 years, China has increased or doubled their farmers' income and also reduced the poverty in the country by half. So what China or Chinese government has done was that they have shifted from commune system of farming to household or making household responsibility farming. Here commune system means it is a combination of many small farmlands or farm halls, or some around 2000 to 5000 households will be part of a commune. So this commune system was not working efficiently for the agriculture sector there. There was lack of competition or lack of interest to come up with better productivity or to come up with efficiency in agriculture sector. So they have moved to this household responsible system. So from India's stand, we can say we have to do the opposite. That means our problem is that of fragmented landholding. That means 80% of people or farmers, they own land less than 2 hectares. So there is the need for pooling of land, or that can be resolved through land leasing, making long-term land leasing laws or favorable for long-term land leasing. So in our country, the problem for solution for the fragmented landholding can be through solved through this landholding, better landholding laws, or to coming up with contract farming. Then again, Chinese government has also made sure one thing, that is they had assured higher price for farmer products, and this is also very absent in our country. For instance, we take China's MSP for wheat in 2014-15, it was found that it was some around, you know, like $385 per ton for wheat. But in our country, the MSP for wheat during that year was $226. So we are way behind the China or how China is providing better income or higher income for farmers' products. So this has to be adopted. When we have to come up with a higher price, that is one of the main reasons for this farmers' distress or agriculture distress. So as to increase the price of different farm products, we have to move away from that consumer bias policy. Then there must be some income policy to poor, so as to support the consumers or poor people. Then we'll have to free up the price for farmers. Other than going for consumer-centric policy, it will be better if government come up with some kind of income policy to support poor people or such kind of consumers, so that farmers also get a higher price and this consumers also will be protected. Then again, we have seen the question or challenge of if productivity is increased, how it can be absorbed in our domestic market, as there is so much regulation in private stockholding. So for this, there must be a free agriculture market. The stockholding limit for private traders must be removed. So they must be allowed to take an active role in agriculture market. This can bring fair price or higher price for agriculturists. Then again, even if there is low domestic demand, then we must go for exports. The restrictions when on export has to be removed. Only then we can become very competitive in the field of agriculture sector. Then we have seen the huge threat from climate change. So it's high time to swiftly adopt to climate smart agriculture practices, like that of even FAO has recommended of using some renewable resources like that of biofuels or solar energy, and going for organic farming or even carbon smart measures like agroforestry, livestock management. So along with the governmental action plans, if these measures are taken, surely we can increase farmers' income to a higher level, even if not double farmers' income. So that can result in that higher farmers' income, but there is a real possibility of doubling farmers' income if we do one thing. That is, it's found that in our country, for any problem in our agriculture sector, there is also a corresponding agriculture program or governmental scheme for that. So it's through that seamless implementation of such program, surely if it is very effectively implemented in our country with all such programs, surely agriculture sector can double its farmers' income. And again, when it is done, we must also commit to go for the sustainable development of agriculture sector. So that can come up with long-term benefit for farmers or the agriculture sector, and it can also lead to inclusive development of a country and also some two-digit growth for our economy. Thank you.